women are on the go. Keeping busy is part of our lifestyle here in Southern California, and comfort is a priority. Casualness dress is fit into this mold, providing us with versatility, style, and comfort unlike any other. So now let's glance at the current fashions in casualness dresses.
The large shoulder pads and snaps add the shape and the style of the design. Many different colored blouses, belts, and shoes can make this outfit different every time you wear it. Summer's key shapes for day are something different. The added appeal of prints, patterns, and darker colors add refreshing charm and impact. These two delightful dresses are worn by Carol Thomas and my sister Robin. The sundress worn by Carol is a simple cut that has been brought into today's fashions with the low hip belt and the small buttons running down the back. This maroon jumpsuit worn by Jill DiOrio is a more easygoing casual piece. It has so much wearability and so much charm. This jumpsuit is perfect for relaxing at home, the country, the beach, and for weekends. This three-piece ensemble worn by Jill Moore makes a great traveling outfit to mix and match with slacks and other dresses. The large stripe combined with the small stripe is an interesting effect in this all-seasonal cotton blend. A unique approach to color and ornamentation is exquisitely shown in this prom dress worn by Chris Banzer. A raw silk in a vibrating color with a sensuous low-cut back add to a fantastic night on the town. No one would ever know that this dress was made in one day, 2 days before the prom. And now, this yellow, black and white checkered skirt has a very real sense of style. Cut big and oversized like a man's, but unmistakably feminine with a long, narrow back, black textured skirt. This blouse is a combination of patterns and my own creativity to make a noticeable look. Thank you.
Thank you.
I have created a line of my own, which will now be presented. My first model is Monica Fasher. She is wearing a blue and white striped shirt, bow pattern, made of pillow tiki. It features a yoke shield with a back pleat and button ankle leg. Her skirt is gathered in 100% cotton, very comfortable and sporty. Heidi Johnson is wearing a simple outfit. The print is the California beach scene. If you'll notice the rounded hemline in front and squared in back, you'll find it interestingly casual. Kim Curtin is wearing a Perry Ellis design red corduroy straight skirt. It has a back pleat and a wide waistband with a buckle. Her shirt is made of 100% cotton. Julie Rapp is wearing what I call my ducky dress. It is a subtle calico printed cotton with a low waist, slightly flared skirt, and patch pockets. My next model, Heather Daywalt, is wearing an Issey Miyake designer original blouse and skirt. The pullover top has a concealed button, closing, and a back pleat. The skirt is a wrap with an uneven hemline. This outfit is stylish, unique, and perfect for summer. The next dress, worn by Don Hamlet, is made of a linen blend. The front and back flanges add an interesting dimension. Cheryl Hanselman is wearing a Carol Horn designer outfit. It is easygoing, contemporary, and fun. My next model, Elizabeth Lawrence, is wearing a classic shirt-waist dress accented by pleats and loosely belted across the back. It is clearly attractive, projecting an image of success, long and clean. Carolyn Case is wearing a lavender satin blouse and skirt. It is clean, sleek, and complemented with a bow. The next dress is being worn by Quinn Scallon. It is dazzling, luxurious, and sophisticated. The low back is very sexy, and the velvet waistband bow is flattering. Finally, the dress I'm wearing is of my own creation. I enjoy outfits which reflect creativity and uniqueness. Before shopping for the fabric, only the style was designed. The selection of prints and colors was spontaneous. The top is made of silk, and the skirt and yoke satin. The skirt is asymmetrical, having only one side pleated. It was not only fun to make, but it's also fun to wear. Thank you.
Versatile as well as comfortable. Casual skirts have become an essential item to any young woman's wardrobe, whether picnicking in the park, on a casual day, or at a summer luncheon. These skirts will catch your eye. See if you agree.
Thank you.
total turnouts with enough finish to go more places. Shorts are becoming an important part of our wardrobe and are one of the most popular items made. This category will give you a glimpse of some of the fashionable shorts our students have made.
Thank you.
see if this is one of my passions. Tropical look is all the rage now, and Sarah looks ready to run out of the town. With brilliant blue gray pants and oversized white cotton shirt. The queer woman is always looking for something new and versatile for her wardrobe. Denise is modeling a bow dress made of pink collar ground in the middle. The chains of accessories can easily go from the office to an evening party dress. Marissa will surely stand out in this sensational at a glance.
Thank you. but creating a different look with each. Whether going out on a date or just working around the house, these flannel shirts can be the easiest and most comfortable way to spend time. Anthony Camisa, known better to most as Grandpa, is wearing the most popular men's shirt that was ever designed. The button-down short-sleeve shirt is made from a lightweight Oxford cloth. The shirt can be worn on a hot day or even to a Sunday golf game. So with her ever-popular stuffed care bear, it's off to bed for Lori. With almost half of California now participating in some form of exercise, Adrian Abel is dressed for success in the athletic world. Adrian is wearing a sweatsuit made of pink velour that can be worn anywhere from jogging on a cool day to a shopping spree on the weekend. With the number of women entering the business world increasing each day, today's woman must be dressed for success. In her pleated linen skirt and crinkle quality blouse, Lisa Hayden could be a success anywhere she went. For the active woman, this is the casual yet sophisticated style you've been looking for. In the new style of excitement and bright colors is shown in the jumpsuit and tank worn by Krista Jarvie. The jumpsuit is made of a gray sweatsuit fleece, and the tank is made of a stretch knit. Dressed for action, Krista is ready for the go. Trends, the innovative quality of life for today. Vitality, creativity, and individuality are all expressed in Gigi Raquel's Danny Noble Designer Ensemble. The straight skirt is black linen, the blouse, white oxford cloth, and the jacket of poly linen blend. Whether dance at school or painting the town, this Vogue outfit allows her to be herself. You're never too old to enjoy dressing up as you did as a child. My sister Susan Carlton is pretending to be Levelock Care Bear, one of the increasingly popular members of the Care Bear family. The dress I am wearing is made of georgette and is an Albert Nippon design for Vogue. This is one of my outfits that went to the DAR National Competition. I received in first place, and I don't know how I got the Nationals as yet. Thank you.
Itself is made of black velvet with a lace V bottom, and the cape is made
chain is in their own design, made of white gold brocade with white chiffon slip underneath. The fabric was brought from China many years ago to be finally made into a stunning evening gown.
Thank you.
Made in 100% wool, it retails for $600, yet only costs her $80 to make. After continuous alterations, Sandra has decided that fitting jackets are not for her. Chris Andrews is wearing a mid-calf coat of black and maroon striped mohair, ideal for those cold winter days, running around campus, or frequenting the clubs. The coat costs $75 to make and would sell for $450. The lightweight 100% wool jacket Margaret is wearing has a unique way of being sporty yet having a casual appearance. Its mixed colors give the fabric the benefit of going with everything. The pleats straightened down the back give a thinning look. The blazer Kelly is wearing is made of a silk and wool blend, a perfect weight for Southern California. A pleated burgundy wool skirt completes the outfit. Stephanie Clem's suit is a Vogue jacket and pants. The jacket is double-breasted, unfitted style. The suit is made of a wool blend in black, gray, red, white, and pinstripe. It was entered in a DAR home economic competition and won first prize. Wearing a Vogue basic design coat out of raspberry and cream silk.
Clothing that follows is a mixture of casual and formal,
Bohemian style.
Thank you.
occasion. The style of the wedding may range from traditional to contemporary. This is a very special day, perfected by the bride's personal touches. Every detail is important. The wedding is a fantasy realized. A prominent part in the celebration of this joyous occasion is the selection of the dress. These girls have created looks which are exquisite and original. The bridesmaids, Dulce Milan and Evita Tovar, are wearing dresses which are made by the bride. The first bride, Lourdes Milan, is wearing a floor-length dress made of white taffeta, satin, and lace. It features loop buttonholes and a hand-curled bodice. She also created her hat, which is accented with lace and pearls. Her escort is Bruce Cooper, who is wearing a tuxedo from Alicia Tux. The next bridesmaids, Amy Thomas and Julie DiMartini, are also first-year sewing students who made their dresses. The flower girl is Courtney, and her dress was made by Amy Thomas. Shannon Bright is wearing a dress modeled after Jessica McClintock. The front collar, which was hand-curled, took 19 hours. Most of the trim was hand-sewn on also. Her gloves were handmade from lace, and the hat featured a white tulle veil and silk flowers. Her escort is Eric Bethke, who is wearing a tuxedo from Alicia Tux. The final bride is Deanne Busby. She designed her white lace and satin dress. It features a drop waist with a white satin bow and hand-beaded and sequined front. Her escort is Rob Diamond, who is wearing a tuxedo from Sears.
And the lucky winner is A. Sandin from Dana Hill. It's this is a certificate good for a $200 partial scholarship of self-development modeling course, and the winner is number 64. Number 64 somewhere?
Hey, David.
Well, if you find your program, you can unload this with Ms. Hansen, then you can go just get it after the show, okay? But just be sure to bring your program.
This next presentation is directed toward the mothers of the senior girls in the show. Come on, please. Sometimes it seems we get so involved in our own interests and activities that we seldom have time to really talk to each other. But we want you to know that you're the most important part of our lives, and that having you to share with makes everything worthwhile for us. So when the days pass so quickly that we can't seem to find enough time to be together, always remember that every moment we spend together is very precious to us. No matter how grown up we may be or how independent we act, no matter the distance between us or the time between visits, no matter what happens today or tomorrow, there's one thing you can always be sure of: how much we love you. You might think we never notice you do for us, the encouraging words you say to us, but we do see them and hear them and appreciate them, and we love you for every single one.
Thank you.
special person who works with us 3 days a week and helps us with all our sewing troubles.
The rest of the balloons are yours, you all. Thank you so much.